held by you. Baby, look what you've done to me.
Because I have loved Hanson since I was 8, and it's like never going to end. I'm never going to stop loving them. And Taylor Hanson has an amazing voice, and also, you know, we're both named Taylor.
And you both have great hair.
Thank you.
You share the blondness.
Thank you so much. Huh? I love John Mayer, but I say that in other interviews. Yeah, I say that in like every interview, so I figured I'd switch it up.
Okay. They are definitely singing it. Now, I know you're not going to name the man who this was about, but I read somewhere that you said it was designed to drive the ex absolutely crazy. What is that about?
I maybe said that one place, maybe, on a bad day. But I think for me, there's more boys now. It's crazy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, there's a lot of guys whenever I look out into the audience. And I... No, it's because you guys are hot and they know where you're going to be.
Concert is that, you know, there's 99% of people going absolutely crazy. And then there's 1% of the concert, which are just humble dads that have brought on probably a bus full of their daughters and daughters' friends.
Chaperone dads.
We've talked to you before about chaperone dads, like this concept of, I mean, they're happy to be there, but, you know, they're clearly with like a gaggle of 16-year-olds. Yeah. You know that they're out there, right?
Yeah, yeah. Usually they're like holding the signs that their teenage daughters have made, and you know, their daughters held the glittery signs for the first half of the show, but then they're like, Dad, hold this! And so, they've got like, you know, like glitter all over their khaki pants and their plaid shirts, and they're like, but they're doing the right thing.
They are doing the right thing.
They're doing the right thing.
A lot of your songs obviously are directed towards the fans, but maybe, just maybe, you could write a song directed towards chaperone dads. So Haim and I got together today.
Is it okay if we have our butler bring in some instruments? We don't have the dobro. So we thought, if we just play a little bit here.
Thanks, Jack.
If we just play a little bit here, and you'll sing a line, I'll sing a line, then we'll go to you for just chaperone dads. And really, however you want to, you know, dig deep here and really express your thanks to chaperone dads. Are you in for that?
Yeah.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we have a special surprise performance here.
Ooh, chaperone dads.
I've mustered the tambourine.
You just got off of work. The last thing you do is wanna do is go and listen to me talk about some breakup.
Chaperone dance.
You're doing the right thing.
Ooh, chaperone dance.
Remember when the tickets went on sale? Your daughter's 14th birthday and you got her 2 tickets. And she said, can I have some more? Because my friends and I all want to go. Dad, you don't have to go, but you know you got to go and chaperone.
Taylor Swift, everybody!
Because I needed a way to vent. So yeah. The first...
Is this vent anger?
Well, vent anger, vent sadness. Yeah. Dear Diary, today I saw a cute boy. I don't think he likes me. Like, that sort of thing. And then I ended up writing songs about exactly the same thing.
Yeah.
And your love interest in the film, in the video, was played by Toby Hemingway, wasn't it? A British actor.
Yeah, he's from
Brighton.
But he
didn't let you down, Taylor, because he couldn't row, could he?
Yeah, there was, it was such a fun video shoot. It was hilarious. And, like, one of the things that everybody was giving him such a hard time about was, like, we're in this rowboat, and we had to eventually get out to the middle of this lake. He was just miserable at rowing a boat, and I had to do it for him, and it was like everybody on the whole set was just like, you can't row a boat, like,
yeah. Oh,
don't you live there? It was like they were like, aren't you from England? He's like, yeah, but we don't have these kinds of boats here. Yeah, yeah. It was so
not
funny.
Good men who can't
poor
row.
Toby.
Oh no. My gosh.
Can you row?
We Are Never Getting Back Together is great one song. Of the biggest pop songs we've ever heard on this station. Congratulations on that too.
Oh my God,
it's massive.
Thank you.
Now, I want to ask an obvious question, and it's not the one that you think it's going to be. I want to know this question. Can you give us an example of the indie records that were way cooler than yours?
Well, see, that was all kind of specific to that particular relationship.
Right.
There are some references to, like, being cooler than me, or, like, indie records or, like, hipsters and stuff like that.
Yes.
All of that is kind of in reference to that relationship that made me feel very insecure.
Oh.
I don't know. This guy was more like, he was, like, the kind of dude that where it was, like, oh, I just went and saw this basement concert, and there were only four people there, but they're starting to blow up now, so I'm really over it.
It was so cool.
How annoying.
Like,
how annoying.
And I'm like, I'm the opposite, you know, like.
And you're recording songs onto your cell phone, and he's going to see basement gigs.
Well, yeah, and also, like, I started to feel like, should I have less people at my concerts?
Yeah, that's right.
I don't want to have less people at my concerts. I really like how things have gone.
Oh, we're glad you got rid of him.
See, this one even comes with a phone. See, so he can break up with other guys. Stay away from him.
Like, you know, I'm buying a house here, and I'm doing this, and I'm this, and
yeah.
It's just sort of like, you have to turn that part of it off, or else it'll get
bland.
I knew you were trouble. Now, these songs are obviously about people. Does anyone avoid you because they think, no, thank you.
No, I don't want to be written about.
I don't want to be written about. I don't want to know you.
Well, if you think about it, if they were avoiding me, I wouldn't really know it.
Yeah.
You're
right.
So maybe.
Yeah.
It's possible. But I've never had someone come up and be like, you know, I really want to ask you out, but, like, if you write a song about me, I would be weirded out by that. Like,
no, that'd be a loser. The loser would say that, right?
No one has ever said, oh, are you going to write about me now?
I bet you they have.
Yeah, I bet they have.
No, I mean, not in the beginning when things are
good.
No,
but more towards the end.
Maybe spitefully.
Yeah.
In an email.